Hello, everybody, and welcome again to Dr. Samuel Math video presentations. And we are going through concepts on the CSEC math syllabus as well as math syllabi from around the world. And we start with fractions. The first question normally on the CSEC examination paper 2 is a fraction and or a decimal question, where you're asked to simplify the fraction or the decimal. And so this is the first video on simplification of fractions. But this video will simply be looking at what is a fraction. Because I have found that many times the problem with answering those questions is a lack of the basic understanding of what is a fraction. And so we're just going to do that today. What is a fraction? And in the next video, we will look at a little more at how we add, subtract, multiply, and divide fractions, like what is given in examinations. So, what exactly is a fraction? Anytime you take part of something, that's a fraction. You take a part out of a whole. And the whole can be anything, whatever you are considering. The whole could be a number, for example, 50. So you can take a fraction out of that number 50. The whole could be an object, for example, a cake or pizza. And you cut out part of the cake or pizza, and that's a fraction. It could be a line, it could be a mass, it could be any quantity or any measurement that you have. You can just take part out, and that is a fraction. But then you have to understand how we measure, how we write fractions. So, if you look at the diagram on the right side, basically, you have a whole circle, and we divide the circle into a number of equal parts. And if we count it, we're going to get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 equal parts. That's the basis of all fractions. A whole is divided into a number of equal parts. From that whole, a number of those equal parts are removed to get a fraction, or are chosen to get a fraction. So for example, in the diagram, you see we have two parts shaded that are pink. In other words, two out of the 8 parts are pink. It means the fraction shaded pink is 2 over 8. The 2 represents the part that you are considering, and the 8 represents the total number of equal parts the whole is divided into. And so using that, you can see 3, 1, 2, 3 parts are shaded yellow. So the fraction shaded yellow is 3 out of 8. And you have 1, 2, 3 parts unshaded. Not 4 as are there, that's a mistake. You have 3 parts unshaded, and so therefore it out, and so therefore the fraction unshaded is 3 out of 8. So the top number of the fraction represents the number of parts of the whole you are considering or is cut out, and the bottom is the total number of equal parts that the whole is divided into. And so the two important terms related to that is the numerator and denominator. The top term of the fraction, the number of parts that are out or chosen, is the numerator. And the bottom number, the total number of equal parts or whole, is divided into. That is the denominator. So in this fraction here, the 3 is the numerator and the 4 is the denominator. That's it. Finally, what do we mean by equivalent fractions? Basically, the definition, simple definition, fractions are equivalent when they are equal fractions, but you have different numerators and denominators. They are equal because they represent the same fraction, the same parts, number of parts taken out of the whole. And the diagram shows you an example of equivalent fractions. If you look at the diagram, we have the same parts of the whole shaded. But in the first diagram, you have one part out of two equal parts, that's a half. In the second, you have two parts shaded out of four equal parts. And in the third, you have four parts shaded out of 8 equal parts. But when you look at it, all the circles just have one part out of 2 shaded. It means a half, 2 over 4, and 4 over 8 are equal fractions. But the simplest way of representing these three fractions is a half. That is writing the fraction in its lowest terms. So, how do we bring a fraction to its lowest terms? And generally, you must do that. If after working out a problem, you get a fraction, always check to see whether you can bring it to its lowest terms. So, if we got 4 over 8 as a solution to a problem, we know it is not in its lowest terms because we can divide both the numerator and denominator by the same factor. As you can see, we can divide it by 2. 2 into 4 is 2. 2 into 8 is 4, and you get 2 over 4. But you can also divide the numerator and denominator by 4. 4 into 4 is 1. 4 into 8 is 2. To bring it to its simplest form, its lowest terms, you divide by the highest common factor. That is the highest factor that can be divided into the numerator and denominator, which is 4. So when you do that, you're going to get 1 over 2, which is the simplest form of representing the fraction 4 over 8. So that is the first video on basically understanding what a fraction is. In the next video, we will now go on to the actual simplification of fractions by adding them, subtracting them, multiplying them, and dividing them. As usual, if you like this video, then you can please subscribe to my channel so you get a lot more like this. You can also like or share. I will see you all next time.